And there is a lot of, if you want to pursue research in computer graphics, there are a lot of requirements or a lot of different knowledge that you want to have. So this may involve a lot of mathematics and a lot of physics. So as you can see for like simulation and lighting, it involves a lot of math and it involves like numerical linear algebra, physics, and all these things. And it, in general, computer graphics borrows a lot of algorithms from, let's say, what you learn in your algorithms class, right? So these are all generic algorithms, and many of them are used every day in computer graphics. And if you know about digital signal processing, so there are things that computer graphics is very strongly related to, some aspects of that. And mechanical engineering, for example, if you want to measure, let's say, if wind is blowing in a very high building, then building might start to sway. So there are all civil engineering and mechanical engineering concepts. For example, fluid dynamics for water flow and all these things. So there are many interesting problems which are still researchers are working on. So I'll give you a very couple of them and leave from here. So for example, for games, like you all see that these days games are becoming very popular and very high-end graphics is there. So for example, as somebody pointed out, that NVIDIA has a lot of graphics cards, and now a lot of things are possible which were not there in games like 10 years back. So for example, you see a very real lighting, very real effects of people in the war, or like World of Warcraft or real life and all these kind of games. But what you need is real-time simulation and rendering. What it means that as the user is playing, you need to display everything at that speed, which is very hard, and that's why you have a lot of approximation and a lot of not so realistic features when you see a game as compared to when you see a special effects movie. And then there is a lot of detailed human-like motion synthesis which is still not there as yet. Like I talked about keyframing and motion capture. So these are all, like, you can capture it once, but you cannot change it a lot, right? So that means if you want to create very different kind of behaviors, let's say if you see people walking out on the road, you see everyone is walking in their own style, but so you can't just go ahead and capture everything, right? That's why you need a process so that you can automatically generate motion. Such as like a video we just saw, like the robot was walking and you were pushing and it is automatically reacting to it. So you want to have these kind of things, and even in games, it is all completely motion capture or like very procedurally generated. It doesn't look very real. Like when you push a cat, when you hit a...
Sumit, I think something gone wrong at their end. Maybe they're just gone. just hold on 1 second. Yeah, I think we're pretty much done. Yeah. So I think just wrap up. I think we cannot probably do the wrap up then. Because, you know, it's not, the internet connection is gone, because I can see that. Okay, I think we should not wait. Like, you know, I think I just give them a call and then find out. Because we didn't wrap up properly. Okay, so let me see, like, you know, what's going on there. Hey, Srikant, I think the internet connection is gone from your end. Okay, so then I think we are about to finish. Like, I don't think he has anything. No, so should we wait or not? That's my question.